Okay, for example, they will read the sentence as maybe you such a liar, I think, because they do not have the prior knowledge of the word liar in English. They will tend to, they have tendency to relate the word liar to L-Y. If they realize the meaning, which is totally misleading, they understood the meaning of the sentence, and they have the tendency to translate the sentence literally. Now next, we have split and skip. Split on the stair means that it's an action, right? You split on the stair and then fall down. And then we have skip.
When you present, you get to the point, don't talk about the same thing over and over.
Yeah.
You get the point, then you move to the next thing. Contrastive lexicology.
The next, I will look to the contrastive lexicology. We'll explain the two subjects, translation theory and bilingual lexicography. For translation theory, it is written from one language to another. In this content, we from English to Malay. Students tend to direct translate the words of L2 into L1. And cultural barriers is the students may not use the right words to translate or tend to translate it word by word. For example, the idiomatic expression. Idioms is a group of words whose meaning is different from the meaning of the individual word. It has a different meaning and different idiomatic meaning in another language. The meaning can be unpredictable. In Bahasa Melayu, we have pre-bahasa or bahasa kiasan. These are the example of idiomatic expression in English and Bahasa Melayu. For Bahasa Melayu, we have ajak-ajak ayam. Whereas in English, we have the warm invitation. Bersengkang mata, it's burn the midnight oil. Musuh dalam simut, smell the rat. Nasi sudah menjadi bubur, tie over a split mouth. And sudah jatuh muka tangga is add salt into the injury. Our prediction is that the students may find a difficulty to understand the idiom, so they understand the individual words as it carries the contrast meaning. L2 students tend to literally translate the English idiomatic expression. Next is bilingual lexicography. It is the entries into bilingual dictionaries. It is active because of there are L2 students and the translator. Bilingual dictionaries is generalizing of obvious mistakes and their negative effect. For example, with the wrong use of verbs, shifting and moving. Verbs have the same meaning in Bahasa Melayu, which is berpindah. However, the students may have the difficulty to use the right word for in a sentence. For example, our company is shifting to the new office suite. However, the right sentence is our company is moving to the new office suite. The prediction is students may find difficulty to choose the correct word of verb. Students have word translation based on L1 characteristics, and students use synonymous words to substitute with each other. So, for the conclusion, cognates may contribute to the student's error in terms of misspelling the words. Voice banks may contribute to the spelling error and misinterpretation of the meaning. Lexical acquisition of L1 may influence the students to generalize the usage of certain words due to its meaning. L1 students tend to do direct translation on the idiom. The next is, L2 students may not understand the idiom as the usage of word in L2 is different from L1. And the students tend to choose the wrong word as it carries the same meaning in L1.
Thank you. This so far the best presentation. Well, I have not much to add. I'm in fact very happy with what you've done. If you maybe you want to have appendix to support whatever you think. Okay. Now, we are done with the presentation. Now this Wednesday, I